So in this lecture, you will discuss about non-Cochon interference. So in the previous lectures, we have discussed the what is Cochon interference and what are the different causes for the Cochon interference. Like if there is a change in the Cochon, it can be reduce the Cochon interference by reducing the antenna height or by changing the directional antenna instead of omnidirectional antenna. By replacing the directional antenna instead of omnidirectional antenna, we can reduce the Cochon interference. Or how can we design all those things we have seen for reduction of Cochon interference. That is one part. And coming to the next, non-Cochon interference, what are the different factors that resulting to non-Cochon interference? What is non-Cochon interference? Everything you will see in this video. And the other part which is there in the unit 2 is cell coverage for signal. So totally this unit 2 consists of three parts, Cochon interference, non-Cochon interference, and cell coverage for signal. So in this lecture, we will cover what is a non-Cochon interference, what are different types, different factors that are affecting the non-Cochon interference. So here, what is meant by non-Cochon interference is, Cochon interference is caused by the co-channel cells. What is meant by co-channel cell? Co-channel cells are the cells which are using the same frequency. So because of using same frequency, there is obviously interference. That interference we are calling as Cochon interference. But coming to non-Cochon interference, not only the channels, co-channels which are using the same frequency are resulting into interference, but the other channels which are adjacent, neighbor, all those channels also will result for the interference. So we will see what are the different types. First, coming to adjacent channel interference. So the scheme discussed for reduction of Cochon interference can be used to reduce adjacent channel interference. However, the reverse, that is, the schemes used for adjacent channel interference cannot be used for Cochon interference. It is not valid. Okay. In addition, the adjacent channel interference can be eliminated. So mainly on the basis of channel assignment, the way we are assigning the channels, there is nothing but frequencies that we will see in the fourth unit very briefly. So next, coming to the filter characteristics. So what is the filter, how we are designing? Depending on that, the adjacent channel interference we can eliminate, and reduction of near and foreign interference ratio. So all these we'll discuss one by one. So adjacent channel interference mainly includes next channel interference and neighboring channel interference. First, what is next channel interference? The channel next to the operating channel is called as next channel interference. Immediate next channel next to the operating is called as next channel interference. Neighboring channel interference is more than one channel, maybe third, fourth, fifth, like that. So more than one channel away from the operating channel is called as neighboring channel interference. So adjacent channel interference can be reduced mainly by frequency assignment. So while giving the frequency, we are assigning the frequency F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, F7 for example, in the case of K is equal to 7 means the same frequencies will be repeated. So while assigning itself, we have to look after what is the frequency that we are assigning to the adjacent channel. So there only we can minimize to some extent the adjacent channel interference. That is the meaning. So next, coming to the first. So in adjacent channel interference, we are having two types, next channel and neighboring channel. We will discuss next channel interference. The next channel interference affecting a particular mobile unit cannot be caused by transmitters in the common cell site, but originate at several other cell sites. So this is because any channel combiner at the cell site must combine the selected channels, normally 21 channels away, or at least 8 or 10 channels away from the desired one. So what is the meaning is that they are taking the precautions in the channel combiner. What is meant by channel combiner is that it will be there at the cell site. It will combine all the channels coming from the mobile unit. This is because any channel combiner cell site must combine selected channels. So normally it will take 21 channels away, or at least 8 or channels away from the desired one. So each frequency F1, F2, F3 they are assigned and they are combined. While combining, they are taking care that each channel is away from minimum 8 or 10 channels. So normally it is 21 channels. 30 kilohertz difference they are taking for F1, F2, F3 while assigning the frequency. Therefore, next channel interference will arrive at the mobile unit from other cell sites. So probably in the same cell site, in the same coverage area, there may be no chance of next channel, but it may happen because of the other cells. That is, the system is not designed properly. So while designing itself, if it is designed properly, means this type of external interference will not occur. Also, a mobile unit initiating a call on a control channel in a cell may cause interference with the next control channel to another cell site. So not only the channels, the control channels will be there. So you'll be seeing the fourth unit in the frequency assignment. There will be control channels, data channels. So the control channels also may initiate a call sometimes in a cell, may cause interference in the next control channel. Okay. The methods for reducing this next channel interference use the receiving end. So we are using the other receiving end, whatever the methods. So the channel filter characteristics are a 6 dB aux slope in the voice band we have to consider, 24 dB aux fall off outside the voice band region we have to consider like this. A 6 dB fall within the B/2 channel band, and out of that we have to consider 24 dB fall off. So these precautions we have to take care of while designing the channel band filter. If the next channel signal is stronger than 24 dB, it will definitely interfere. So it should be that in the design itself, after survey, they have kept the channel that is filter, sorry, it's not channel, filter characteristics in such a way that the channel filter characteristics are 6 dB aux slope in the voice band and 24 dB aux fall off in the outside the voice band. So if the next channel signal is stronger than this 24 dB, definitely the interference will occur with the desired and strong signal. So the filter with the sharp fall off slope can help to reduce the adjacent channel interference. So including the next channel interference. So next channel interference is one among the adjacent channel interference. The same consideration is applied to digital systems also. So next is coming to the neighboring channel interference. The channels that are several channels away from the next channel, that is a second, third, fourth. So not adjacent channel is called as next channel. So the channel that are several channels away from the next channel will cause interference with the desired signal comes under the neighboring channel interference. So usually a fixed set of serving channels is assigned to each cell site. If all the channels are simultaneously transmitted at one cell site antenna, a sufficient amount of band isolation between the channels is required. So for one channel to another channel, there should be band isolation. So that should be taken care of when designing the system. So for a multi-channel combiner to reduce the intermodulation products, this requirement is no different from other non-mobile radio systems. So assume that band separation requirements can be resolved. For example, by using multiple antennas instead of one antenna on the cell site, there will be no intermodulation products. We told here that there is a requirement to reduce the intermodulation products. So we can reduce that by using multiple antennas. There will be no intermodulation products. A truly linear broadband amplifier can realize this idea. So however, it is a new evolving technology. So we have to take care of all these for reducing the neighboring channel interference. So another type of adjacent channel interference is unique to the mobile radio system. In the mobile radio system, mobile units are in motion simultaneously. So the relative positions change from time to time. So in principle, the optimum channel assignments that avoid adjacent channel interference must also change from time to time. It should be adaptive. So as the positions of the mobile change from time to time, the optimal assignments of channels also should be changed from time to time. So one unit station that causes adjacent channel interference is described in the next section. Okay, in the next video, we will discuss the